This is FOMAS Solutions. You are welcome to the continuation of our discussion as far as proof by mathematical induction is concerned. I want to look at another example. So let's pick example 2. Yeah, we are proving that, proof that 1 cube plus 2 cube plus 3 cube and so on up to n cube is actually equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3 so on n plus n so r to the power 2. And I'll be doing this for all n being elements of the set of natural numbers. Right, so you recall that for proof by mathematical induction, there are certain steps that we need to follow. So the first thing to do here is to prove directly that this statement is true for the first element of the set of natural numbers. So that first element will be all to 1. So first you say that for n equals 1, we want to see whether the statement is true. But before we do that, now, in the subsequent discussion, we made a certain proof concerning this. So you should be able to recognize this one as being, for instance, so know what we have learned already is that for 1 plus 2 plus 3 and so on up to n, then this should be equal to half of n. Then n plus 1. Right, so in effect, we'll be having the proof written as 1 cube plus 2 cube plus 3 cube and so on, n cube, which equals, so all this becomes this. So we have 1, that's half of n, n plus 1. Alright, so we are good to go. So from here, you can look for n equals 1, that's the first step. So for n equals 1, we want to see whether the statement is true. So we are doing that for the left hand side and also for the right hand side. So for the left hand side, what do we do? We just substitute 1 for n. Any place that we see n, we put 1. So putting 1 here will still give us 1 cube, that is what, 1. So the left hand side we have 1. So moving to the right hand side, so the right hand side, so we still substitute 1 for n. So we have half of 1, 1 plus 1, and all this square. We realize that 1 plus 1 gives us 2, multiplied by half, which is given as 1. So you see that the right hand side is also equal to 1. The ones, this side is also 1, that one is also 1. Then we have proved directly that this particular statement is true. Okay. But from there, we move to the next step, which is the assumption stage. So at this point, we assume that this particular statement is true for n equals k. So we are assuming that for n equals k, then the summation. So we are summing up, so to write it simpler, we are having the sum, so I look at the numbers, they are cubed. So I cube, where I begins from 1 up to what? K. Because saying n equals of k. So n equals k equals, so any place we see n in this expression, we're going to write as k. So we have that being equal to half of k into brackets k plus 1. Then also good. So we're assuming that this one is actually true. Now, based on this assumption, we can prove that this particular statement is true for n equals k plus 1. So we're saying that point 3, so point 3, I'm using the assumption in 2. So we are using the assumption in 2. What are we using it for? We're proving that, for n equals k plus 1, so for n equals k plus 1, then the summation I cube, where I begins from 1 up to k plus 1, is equal to, so in this place we see n in this particular expression, we put k plus 1, so we have half of, so k plus 1. So we come again, then here you have what, n plus 1. So putting k plus 1 here will result in we having k plus 2, then all squared. So we have that all squared. Okay. So this is what we prove. Okay. Let's look at the main proof. Plus one here. So plus k plus one. Good. Alright, so This is equal to k plus 1, so you're writing this, and the main business is here. All that we're going to do here is to just look for us. You know that this one has a denominator of 1, this one too has a denominator of 1, but this is of 4. So it means that we can write 4 as the LCM of this. So what this one goes here 4 times, 1 time, multiplied by k squared out of k squared, and this will give us 1, it goes here 4 times, multiplied by that to give us 4 k then plus 4. And we're getting that. Alright. So this is equal to k plus 1 squared. So we see if we can rewrite the top there. So simplifying what is at the top, we're going to have k plus 1. Okay, k plus 2 all squared divided by 2. So we have this. Alright. Good. So this actually is going to give us something interesting. You realize that this one is k plus 2 squared divided by what? 4. So we can rewrite this in a very special way. Then k plus 1 squared. And then this one can be written as k plus 2 then divided by 2 all squared. You see that this, once simplified, will result in that. Alright, so you also realize that this and this are multiplying and they are all being squared. So you can put all multiply them together in squared. So we are in k plus 1. Then multiply by k plus 2. Alright, so and so we divide all this by 2 and to the square here. Alright, good. What are we proving? So using this, we should prove that the whole thing becomes half of this, this, and that. So we just write it to look like what we have here. So we have half of k plus 1, k plus 2, all squared. So once we've been able to manipulate the left hand side, and it is now looking like the right hand side right here, it means the proof is done. So the fourth step is just to conclude. Alright, so look at the last step as a concluding aspect of the proof. So point 4, conclusion. Alright, so let's say that for all n being elements of the set of natural numbers, then the sum of 1 cube, 2 cube, 3 cube, and so on, n cube is actually equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3, and so on, n all raised to the power 2. Alright, so thanks very much for your attention. We shall meet again to look at other aspects of this particular concept. Thank you very much.
This one is Python. Which one?
The one that you just looked at.